They call me Traveler. By day, I am an ordinary man. A Native American man, to be sure, but just an ordinary Native American man. I rise at dawn to pray to the Creator and the Six Directions, as my forefathers have done since the beginning of time. I pray to the east from where the sun rises, to the south, the source of peace and warmth, to the west, where our spirits journey, to the north, the source of purity and goodness, to Father Sky, who watches over us, and to Mother Earth, who gives us life. I seek a blessing from them and stand in the middle so all is balanced. Then, like any man with responsibilities to himself and others, I dress for the day and go to work. In the physical sense, I take care of my children and grandchildren as best I can. But on a deeper level, I think I failed them somehow. It's hard being an Indian man in today's world of go, 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 buy this, consume that, wear these clothes, drive this kind of car. I am at odds with it all. My timing is Indian timing. My rhythms are the earth's rhythms. I am swimming upstream, against the current. My teachings and values have been relegated to the dustbin of history. My people are looked upon as quaint relics of a forgotten time. Oh, look at the nice Indian, they say. Or if they think my tribe has a casino, it's, oh, look at the rich Indian. I struggle with these things day in and day out. By the end of each day, I am exhausted by the drain of this corporate consumer culture in which I exist. During the day, my spirit waits, quietly, patiently. It waits for this ordinary Native American man to go to sleep. It is then that my spirit awakens. I rise up in my true nature, my spirit nature, to begin my nightly journey between the world of shadows in the world of light. It is in this other world that your vision of your own immortality becomes crystal clear. During our Indian ceremonies, you sometimes glimpse this vision as well, this vision of your own immortality. If it is a really good ceremony, led by a pure and powerful person, with the blood of the ancient ones running in his veins, and if your intention is clear, sometimes you get to see it. In my nightly journey, my spirit moves through the land of the so-called living, but I go unnoticed. No longer do I struggle against the current. I am invisible to the current, no more than a shadow in their world. I listen, and soon I hear the drum. It calls to me and others like me, who travel beyond the waking realm. The drum calls us to the gathering. The gathering, where flesh and spirit mingle, where those who are truly awake and those who are truly alive come together. Held in a place that is nowhere and yet everywhere, filled with light in a world of light. It feels like memory, looks like eternity, and sounds like destiny. Here there is no tick-tock time clock to punch, no policeman, politician, or preacher to disapprove, no beginning, no middle, no end. And then this ordinary Native American man awakens once again to the world of time, to the world of place. But he remembers. He remembers his journey in the night to the world of light. And he finds sustenance for another day among the mortals, another day in the world of shadows.